The Bahamas spends millions on the food import bill annually, and government is hoping to cut that down through sustainable farming programming right in your backyard. Communication provider Alive is also promoting the same and has created its own sustainable backyard farming program. Chief Alive Officer Damian Blackburn says they will be providing residents with starter kits.
The kit includes 120 seedlings, gloves, spade, water hose, and a cutlass. We are working with Bamsey. The first trays of crops who were planted in July, on July the 30th, included cabbages, sweet peppers, tomatoes, carrots, bananas, papayas, beans, and many others. I look forward to the first meal served up with that lot.
Agriculture Minister, the Honorable Michael Pintar, commended officials of the mobile network for partnering with them.
We are grateful for this relationship that we are establishing with Alive, who have demonstrated in a wide variety of ways their commitment to the Bahamian society through very innovative programs, and their leadership has shown that they are prepared to be hands-on in terms of making sure that the initiatives they support financially, they are manifesting these initiatives through what they do as a corporate citizen. So I would like to say to the executives of Alive to continue to be a pace setter in demonstrating what good corporate governance is.
Minister of Agriculture and Marine Resources, the Honorable Michael Pintar, recently visited the island of Abaco and met with officials of Dunlap Petroleum, a Bahamian power supply startup, hoping to generate up to 24 megawatts of power at a proposed plant in Spring City using biomass technology and locally grown elephant grass. As the project has been in the making for some 5 years and has garnered significant interest from Bahamas Power and Light, Minister Pintar believes the potential to increase production of non-food agricultural products, particularly on the island of Abaco. Some 5,600 acres of land owned by the Bahamas Agricultural and Industrial Corporation has already been secured for the project. Now, the agreement allows Dunlap Petroleum to study the land, water table, as well as conduct soil tests to determine optimal growth rates for the proposed biomass material. The plant, if approved by Cabinet, is expected to significantly impact employment on Abaco, and the company says that with that Cabinet approval, they will be ready to operate within 24 months.